first of all, a big thanks to Martijn, but also to the organizing team of Reshaping Work to present this research, which I did together with Martijn Arets and Sandra Fischer from the Fachhochschule in Münster, which is closely located to Enschede, Twente, where I am, where I'm located. And what I want to share with you are the results of a survey study that we conducted and that about 1,100 platform workers took place from the very same platforms that Judith also talked about. And what we were interested in this study was the question, hey, under what conditions are the workers in utility or usefulness in taking their current online reputation, a five-star reputation from the platform where they currently work to another platform, what Judith called the source platform. And the starting point of answering that question was that this might be very much dependent on the current reputation which they have on the platform that they work for, or the source platform where the reputation is coming from. So also in line with the question that Bill asked, so we did look into, hey, does the level of reputation, does that have an effect on, well, in this case, how workers see any usefulness in taking their reputation to another platform. So basically the question that we wanted to answer in this study is, so to what extent and why does one's current level of online reputation on a scale from 1 to 5 on a source platform where a worker is currently working relate to the perceived usefulness of taking that reputation to another platform, to the target platform? So to answer this question, we made the following research model. So at the heart of this model lies the idea that one's current level of reputation is related to the perceived usefulness or the perceived utility of taking that reputation to another platform. And to explain why this relationship and also how this relationship manifests, we draw on how workers perceive their relationship to the platform that they currently work for. So more specifically, we draw on the concept of commitment to explain how the current level of reputation is related to perceived usefulness of reputation transfer. So on the one hand, we study the role of effective commitment, and one could define effective commitment as the desire of platform workers to continue working with the platform that they currently work for because they have an effective relationship with that platform. So they like the platform and its representatives, and that's the reason why they feel committed to it. And the thinking is that one's current level of reputation on the source platform is positively related to effective commitment. The literature on human resource management and work psychology predicts that this level of reputation or the reputation score itself is a resource, and that workers are very much likely to reinvest resources. And one way how they do that is by building an effective relationship with the platform, in this case, where they got that score from. And then our thinking was, well, if someone has a high level of effective commitment, they're less likely to leave that platform, so they would also see less utility in taking their reputation to another platform, provided that reputation transfer can be seen as a ticket out of the work setting where you currently work. So then the thinking would be the higher level of reputation, the less likely that workers see utility in taking their reputation support to another platform. But there can also be another reason why one's current level of reputation could positively relate to perceived usefulness. And to understand this, we can draw on the concept of continuous commitment. Well, what is continuous commitment? Whereas effective commitment relates to the desire to stay, someone wants to stay. Continuous commitment refers to a situation where someone needs to stay. Because if one leaves the platform, then the individual will incur a loss. Well, that could happen, for instance, because these reputation scores, they lock in workers, what Judith was also talking about. So you invested time and energy to build a reputation on the source platform. And if you, without reputation transfer, you would leave that platform, then all that investment is gone. So here the thinking would be if you are locked in into this platform, then reputation transfer would allow you to go to another platform without losing all the investment which you did to build the reputation on the source platform. So under these conditions, high levels of reputation on a source platform could also increase the perceived utility to take your reputation to another platform. But this might not hold for all workers, because for some workers, there is no major issue in being locked into a platform, and it's okay for them to work for only one platform and that's it. So whereas for other workers, and especially those who are dependent on platform work for their income and therefore need to work for multiple platforms to make ends meet, for such workers, lock-in effects might be especially detrimental. And for such type of workers, it would be more likely that if they perceive that they are locked in, that they experience high levels of a continuous commitment, that they're more likely to see utility in taking their reputation to another platform, because that allows them to multi-home. Okay, now the results. So I will start with some descriptives. For most of you who have studied online ratings, this graph should not come as a surprise. As you can see, the average online reputation of the workers that we studied is highly skewed to the right. So on average, the majority of workers have a relatively high online reputation. We also see the same happening more or less with perceived utility. So the majority of respondents in our studies or in our study agree that taking their reputation to another platform can be useful for them. Then with regards to the perceived relationship that these workers have with the platform. So we see a nice distribution of effective commitment. So some are not committed to the platform, some feel strongly effectively committed with the platform, and the majority is in between. So they are okay with staying, but they would also be okay with leaving that platform. This picture is more complicated when it comes to continuous commitment. So one could also translate this into the perceptions that workers have as to whether they are locked into the platform or whether they have no option to escape and that they have to stay with this platform. So as you can see on the left, there are many workers who perceive not to be locked in, whereas if you see on the right, well, there is a proportion of workers who perceive that they will incur losses if they leave the platform that they are currently working for. And this also brings me to how workers, or the degree to which workers feel dependent for their income on their platform, and whether they would run financial risks if they were to leave the platform. Well, the picture is rather diverse. There are workers who don't feel dependent on their income, don't feel dependent on platform work for their income, whereas some do. And this also is reflected in the degree to which workers perceive that they need to engage in multi-homing. Most of them seem to be rather ambivalent. As you can see, the spikes are in the middle of the graph. Some don't feel the need to multi-home, whereas others on the right-hand side of the graph do. So how does this all translate into the relationship between these different variables? Well, so in general, we see that one's current level of reputation is positively and significantly correlated with perceived usefulness. So the higher your online reputation, the more likely you workers see utility in taking their reputation to another platform. And in line with our predictions that the higher the level of reputation score, the higher levels of continuous commitment, so the more workers feel that they are locked in, and therefore the more likely they are to take their online reputation to another platform. This relationship was, by the way, not affected or moderated, if you will, by the need for multi-homing or the level of dependence on platform work for one's income. What we found surprising, though, is the role that effective commitment played. So as you can see here, is that the higher the level of one's current reputation on the source platform, the higher levels of effective commitment. So the higher your score, the more effectively committed you feel, and the more likely you want to stay with the platform. That's what we predicted. But contrary to what we expected, is that effective commitment is positively related to perceived usefulness. So the more you want to stay with that platform, that you currently work for, the more likely you perceive to see utility in taking your reputation to another platform. Well, one way how that could be explained is that, especially during the pandemic when this study was conducted, there might have been too little work on the platform where you are currently working and where you want to stay. But in order to stay working as a platform worker, one way how to go about this is to work for other platforms, so to engage in multi-homing. So in order to stay with the platform that you like to work with, you have to work with other platforms in order to generate at least sufficient work. And that is something which can be supported by taking your reputation to another platform. And another result also more or less confirms this thinking. So we found that the higher the level of dependence on platform work for income, the more likely workers are to engage in taking their reputation to another platform. And why is that so? Because those that are dependent on platform work also reported a higher level of need to engage in multi-homing and to work for different platforms. So one of the conclusions that we draw on the basis of this study is that workers don't necessarily see reputation transfer as a ticket to leave a platform and enter another one, but it's much more likely that reputation transfers see my workers as a way to engage in multi-homing rather than leaving one platform and staying with the other. But I think we also have to do more qualitative research to see, okay, but what's really behind this perceived usefulness and why, and what sense do workers make of the possibility to take one's reputation from one platform to the other. So that said, I want to thank you for your time and listening, and I'm looking forward to the remainder of this session. Thank you.
Jeroen, thanks very much for your contribution. It's really nice to really have some insights in the subjects we are talking about and not talking with. So I think that's already really positive one. And also because of the collaboration with the platforms, we could also reach such a big group of gig workers. Yeah. I see some questions. The question of Philly, I think we need to save for the Q&A. And for the panel, because I think it's a more broader question. There's one question from Nicole. How large are the effect size of the significant results?
Let me see.
It's the last question in it yet.
Yeah, so the effect sizes you could see on the screen. Well, I think what would make most sense if I share my slides afterwards, and then people can... then they have the time to have a look at these more closely. But I must say that in general, the effect sizes, especially for the effects of one's current reputation on reputation, the perceived utility of reputation transfer were not that high. What seemed to be having a much stronger effect is one's dependence on a platform for one's income and whether one wants to engage in multi-homing.
Okay, great. So thank you very much, Jeroen. We're also looking forward to hear more about the next steps we're going to do with the data, because we've got now quite some data, and because it was also a quite long list. So I think that then also the size of 1114 respondents is really nice.